Hi, I'm Channing McCorriston, the Container Guy. In this video, we're gonna let you follow along as Will tries out our new steel stud brackets. He's gonna take what he learns in the field, bring it back to the engineers, and then they're gonna adjust our design if needed and finalize this product so that it is super handy for everyone out there in the public to utilize when they're framing their shipping containers. Stay tuned. Get to work.
The distance right from the casting, minus off roughly an inch or two per side. About 3.5 or 1.5.
Going well.
Why don't you pre-drill it?
The reason why, my drill's over there. Yeah.
Thank you.
all about looking professional.
Put it in right there.
Make me sound like Darth Vader. Like something.
So what we've learned from William doing her is that we've added these slots for the studs, and so now the studs in the corners, they're only gonna go here. We're not gonna even put an angle flashing in the inside corner, just so we can get some nice spray foam in here, and the plywood can span that couple inches there, no problem. But we love these Zeal stud brackets and corner casting cover kits. They define the plane of the ceiling. They define how far your wall needs to be away from the side walls, and then the corner casting cover deals with the end walls. So you might notice here, the biggest question that we had was, okay, we figured out how far down we need to be, we figured out how far from the side wall we need to be, but how far does this thing need to be from the end wall? And what we've done is, this plane here on the corner casting cover, we want it to perfectly match the edge of this corner post, and then this plane here matches this edge of this corner post. So that worked out pretty much perfect. What that's done is it's made the gap between here, instead of it being 2 inches, which is ideal, it's gonna be 1.875, which is fine. But now we have a nice visual sight line in two places of where to install this thing, and you're always gonna do it perfectly. And then your top stud here holds this nice and straight, and I've just slid this stud in. I haven't screwed it yet, but it will just screw in right here, go down to your bottom track. So now we can do this completely backwards. We can frame the ceiling, then work down to the floor. That works great. Sneak peek, we think we have figured out a wood stud bracket that will mount up here that'll allow you to run a wood 2x4. So you get some really nice solid ceiling studs. It'll be quite different, and I'm really excited to show you guys, but I just careful what I wanna say now, because Yeah, we're still working on it, but it's gonna be super exciting, and we might even come up with a way to spray to insulate containers without spray foam. So that's super exciting. So yeah, hope this helped here. Watching William struggle, this is one step closer. We are gonna have another video coming out in the next couple of weeks. It's gonna follow us along as we build out an entire container every step of the way. And that'll be very important for you guys to watch if you guys are looking to steel stud and insulate your C-can. So if you enjoyed this video, please help us out, give it a like. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe to our channel and ring that bell for notifications. And as always, check us out at tcg.ca. Hope you learned something.